This is the format we're going to follow, is that very shortly the finance minister will stand up and deliver a short speech. Then I will ask him some questions, and then we will ask all of you for questions for us, or for the minister in particular. I'm not going to give the minister a very long introduction because very few are needed. As the announcer said, he's both the finance minister and also the deputy prime minister. In a previous life, he ran his family's cement company or cement part. He represented Japan for clay pigeon shooting at the Olympics, and he was also prime minister himself. I don't think anyone needs any greater introduction than that. Mr. Prime Minister, please give your speech.
Taro Aso. Well, thank you all for your coming. Well, it is nice to be back here. I joined last year, I think, and join you all for this discussion. Well, let me tell you something. It was in the mid 1960s when I was a student at Stanford doing a graduate work. I stood on Snob Hill in San Francisco, so-called Snob Hill, in San Francisco, watching a brand new Toyota car brought in from Japan, and able to climb up the hills because of the horsepower was so weak, not strong enough. Can you believe that? Toyota, that couldn't, but that was a real story. In the end, a Japanese friend of mine, who was actually from Nissan Motors, and I myself helped push the Toyota car up. This was about the time when Tokyo hosted the 1964 Olympic Games. I was much younger, and so was Japan. Japan was, Toyota was, like that little engine who said, I think I can someday. And as you all know, finally, the little engine could climb up the hill. Maybe it is now time for people in Japan to remember. They were once all like the little engine that made it happen. Artificial intelligence or AI, Internet of Things, IoT, and Society 5.0, no one knows for sure how the technology will change our world. Only one thing is certain: we must change and take risk. Otherwise, we can't grow. Back in the 60s, they told each other in Japan, I think I can. We think we can. They love to challenge and taking risks. How can we have such an environment again? How can we encourage the young to be bold and face up to challenges? With that question in mind, let me turn to our agenda for today. What do I see from my office in Tokyo? Tokyo, ladies and gentlemen, is still clean and even more beautiful than ever before. I also see Japan's social fabric still intact. Japan is even more crime-free. Take a look at the number of the criminal offense in Japan. In the year of 2002, it was more than 2.8 million criminals. Last year, it was down to fewer than 1 million. An all-time low after the Second World War ended. There is no doubt that people in Japan endured hardship in a graceful way. During the slump, economic slump, Japan underwent even a quiet revolution. Lots and lots of things have changed. From corporate governance, the bureaucracy, political system, to female labor participation, it is amazing how far Japan has come from what she was like back in the 1960s. The female labor participation rate in Japan back in 1987 was 53.3%. In the same year in America, it was 62%. Now this is reversed. 2015 in Japan, the female labor participation rate was high as 64.6%. And in America, it was 63.4%. Corporate accounting, that is now the transparent, very much so. If you are a CEO, you fear the shareholders so much that you never spend too much on whining or entertaining. It is no wonder that in Ginza, some of you know where it is, the posh nightlife district, you now see the fewer and fewer chauffeur-driven black sedan cars and more coaches or buses filled with the Chinese shoppers. Do I miss the Ginza of the days gone by? Yes, of course I do. Then what about corporate governance? In this regard, Japan has changed also very, very much. 8 out of 10 listed companies now have more than 2 non-executive independent members of the board. As a result, corporate Japan is paying a lot to shareholders. Dividends now total more than 10 trillion yen or $90 billion, some 2% of GDP. The previous record was mere 6 trillion yen. That much being our quiet revolution. Now finally, capital investment is up, consumption is up, wages and salaries are also up. Well, recession under the deflation is now a thing of the past. All that is good news. But it is common knowledge that our welfare payments are now a serious burden. Their gross total now stands at $1,062 billion. $1,062 billion. That is bigger than the defense spending of the 5 biggest military spenders of the US, UK, South Arabia, Russia, and United Kingdom all put together. A welfare superpower, that is Japan. It is no wonder young men and women are much, much more risk averse. That, ladies and gentlemen, brings me back to the question I told you before. The big question is how we can promote the courage among them. How can we make them welcome challenges? How can we make them that little engine that could buy the cherishing risks? To that end, my ministry, Ministry of Finance, is doing a lot. And let me tell you what we introduce: a tax incentive for SMEs, small mid-sized business, that spend more on the capital investment. Another incentive: encourage the companies to spend more on research and development. Yet, Yet another is for those that hire more. Still another is for those improving governance. Why are we doing them? For such a long time, Japanese companies focused only on reducing the debt obligations. That was an outcome of the bubble burst, recession under the deflation. They had to do it anyway. But consequently, they did it for such a long, long time, more than two decades, that many of them forgot how to spend wisely, if I may say so. Saving makes your balance sheet more solid. But you must spend, I should repeat now. Only by spending money, you can change and you can grow. Ladies and gentlemen, what we are doing at the Finance Ministry is to remind Japanese companies and individuals how to spend money wisely. In order to grow and in order to embrace the challenges ahead, Abenomics, ladies and gentlemen, is all about the future. It is our children and our children's children who must be able to stand tall in an ever-changing world. Abenomics is for them. My ministry is also for the future generations. More broadly, it is becoming more difficult for political leaders to focus only on our future generations. Or too often, we care only about headlines. It is almost as if a specter is haunting us all, the specter of populism. Who is the victim here? Always it is our future generation, our children's children, those with little or no voice that are the victims. That is why we must resist populism. Populism is our enemy number one. The best way to resist populism is for us in politics to work harder than ordinary folks, and to be disciplined. That is easy to be said, but hard to be done. But that, ladies and gentlemen, is at the core of our administration. Shinzo Abe's administration is run by those of us working hard, and I'm telling you that as someone in his late 70s. We are showing our commitment every day to our people. We are providing the nation with consistency. We are also giving a continuity to the country. There are the three C's: commitment, consistency, and continuity. It is vital to work that way for us to resist the populism. It is also crucial for us to tell the young that we are doing a lot for the sake of our future generations. It is to tell them that the future can be better than the present, that they can believe in their own future, that they can grow like that little engine that eventually could. I must stop here. But I can't stop before saying something most important. We are a country of the three seas, as I told you. It is an island of the stability in the waters that are turbulent. It is a country that underwent many changes for the better. So invest in Japan. Spend some time as you can obtain your permanent visa faster than anywhere else. You can't imagine, but that's true. By what we have to offer, Thank you so much.
Oh, sorry. Thank you very much, Finance Minister. That was a very moving journey from Nob Hill to the enthusiasm that all politicians should work harder, which many of them may not agree with. You talked about the need to spend wisely. You talked about that. And if you look at the Japanese economy, you've had 5 quarters of growth, which is fantastic. But you do have this issue about inflation still being barely above zero. What can we do? What can you do to change that other than pushing people to spend wisely?
Okay, from now, you may hear my beautiful English with our translators. And that way to keep her job.
You're on an employment program. Yes.
足元の消費者物価っていうのを見ると、現時点では 2% にいっていないという、達成できていないということは事実です。
Of course, it is true that when we look at the current level of the consumer's price, it has not achieved 2%.
ただし、物価動向に与える影響については、賃上げは3年連続 2% 以上。なっていますし、雇用というものは失業率が 3% 以下ですし、所得環境の改善は続いていく中で、経済の需給環境を示す GDP のギャップも縮小する傾向にあることは事実です。そういった改善が続いていますので、今後は緩やかな回復基調のもとに物価は緩やかに上昇していくと思っています。
However, if you turn your eyes to the environment which influences the trend of the prices, we could say that a wage hike rate posted more than 2% 3 years in a row. And if you look at the employment situation, our unemployment rate is less than 3%, and our income environment is also improving.And if you look at the GDP gap, which reflects the supply and demand situation of the entire economy, we could also say by fact that it's been trending to be narrowed down. So we could say that improvement continues. And going forward, under the moderate undertone of the recovery of the economy, we expect that our prices would also likewise continue to go up moderately.
引き続き、日本銀行と日本の政府との関係は今極めて密な関係にありますので、我々としてはあらゆる政策を動員してデフレ脱却、デフレ不況からの脱却というものを通して力強い経済成長を目指していきたいと考えています。
So continuously at the moment, BOJ and Japanese government are working very closely together in a very good way so that we will continue to fully mobilize all the tools available to us and would do our best to lift the economy out of the deflationary recession and continue to aim at realizing robust growth.
問題は民需主導のいわゆる好環境というものの確立ということなんですが、これは高水準の企業っていうのはすごく増えてきてますんで、ここはまず賃上げをしてもらわないかん。それから設備投資に金を回していくということがまず大事です。
And the issue of how to create a virtuous cycle led by the private demand.Of course, we are seeing a number of corporate earnings being achieving a very high level, yet these companies haven't worked fully to come up with a wage hike as a result of that. So we have to see that moving up. And also, the funds should be channeled more to the capital investment. That's one thing.
政府としては来年の税制の改正において、研究開発税制やまた所得拡大促進税制の見直し、また中小企業向けのいわゆる設備投資 促進税制というものの拡充というのを行っているところで、民間の積極的な取り組みに大いに期待をしています。
So as far as the government is concerned, on the point about the tax regime change for the upcoming fiscal year, we had done a reviewing of the tax incentive system for the R&D, as well as the taxation system to promote the income expansion, and also have done a bit to fulfill more the tax incentives. We could also result in the more promoted capital investment. So we expect very much that as a result of it, the private sector will be able to react rather forthcomingly.
また中長期的には経済成長というものの実現に向けては構造改革への取り組みが重要なんであって、 IoT とか AI を活用など第四次産業革命の実現というものに目指した生産性の向上や、また働き方の改革というものなどを通じた労働生産性の向上、労働供給の増といった改革を一体的に進めるなど、あらゆる政策を通じて今後ともアベノミクスの一層加速していく、そういうつもりでおります。
Also, from the mid to long-term point of view, in order to realize the economic growth fully, what is important is to continue dealing with the structural reformspecifically utilizing more IoT and AI to realize what is called Industry 4.0 to result in the enhancement and the improvement of the productivity, and also try to aim at improving the labor productivity and the labor increase of supply through work style reform. In other words, all these specific items pertaining to the reform should be progressed in an integrated fashion.That is why Abenomics will further be accelerated by mobilizing all the tools available to our government.
Do you worry at all that the things you described at the beginning of your speech, the social fabric, the desire to protect the environment, this very cohesive society where the young, as you say, they don't like taking risks, do you think those...some good things may also be now ingrained in the Japanese social fabric so much that spending money is now something that the Japanese don't want to do?
間違いなく今欲しいものがないと言われる人が増えてくるほど、今新しいものを買おうとしない。例えば若い人が車を買おうとしない。なぜなら東京の交通を見れば、東京の通勤者は 73% は地下鉄、電車等々で、いわゆる自動車、バス等々の通勤を全然使っていないという、いわゆるインフラストラクチャーの発展というものがそういった需要を抑えているという面は確かにあります。
Well, definitely, I could say that there are many increasingly large number of people who don't have anything to buy anymore, nothing desired to be bought. It can be said for buying new things. Particularly, younger people do not care to buy cars, for example. Why? Look at the traffic situation in Tokyo. 73% of the commuters usually commute to their offices either through using the subway, underground, or the railway. Which means that they don't hardly use automobile nor the buses for commute anymore. And because of the good development seen in the infrastructure, the demand for that has gone down.
今東京でインターランドとして約3000万人ぐらいが住んでる、東京の周りで住んでると言われてますけれども、トラフィックジャムが少なく公害があれだけ少ない最大の理由は地下鉄、電車等々の公共乗り物の発達のおかげです。ちなみに一番進んでいるというロンドンで約 10% ぐらいですから、そういった意味では間違いなく消費するものの対象が変わってきたことは確かです。
So, what is called the hinterland portion in Tokyo, the surrounding areas of metropolitan Tokyo where 30 million people live, they are living under the environment where traffic jam is very small, so is the air pollution and so forth. And the largest reason for that is because of the development made in the mass transit system, mainly the railway and the subway system. So perhaps next to Tokyo, the London situation might come up, but I have to say that objects that people would like to buy in terms of the consumables have been declining in availability and in its wants.
企業はそれに対して新しい商品の開発は少子高齢化が進んでいるにもかかわらず若い人の方の商品開発に熱心で金を持っている高齢者に対する商品開発には極めて非積極的、消極でした。それが今の消費が伸びない理由の大きな理由の一つです。
So, look at the new product development efforts made by the companies. Despite the ongoing lowering of the birth rate and the aging of the population, they tend to get more enthusiastic about developing new products that would suit the preference of the younger ones. They don't look at the developing the new product for the elderly who are really the rich people, and companies tend to be so negative about being enthusiastic about developing consumables that would fit the preference of the elderly people. And that's one of the reasons why in Japan the consumption is not rising.
今、いわゆる百貨店、デパートメントストアというのところで売れている商品というのを見たら間違いなく高齢者用の高級のものが多く売れ始めているというのが事実です。したがって多くの企業が商品開発を高齢者向きのものに変わりつつあるというのは一つの流れだと思いますが今言われたように若い人と同時に金を持った高級の人たちがただただ貯金してるだけでは意味がないんで貯金はもう1760兆円16兆ドルの個人金融資産というものを表だけで持ってますからそのお金がじーっとしているというところが一番問題なんであってこれが投資に回るもしくは消費に回るというようにしていくというのが一番大きな一番やらねばならぬ流れだと思っています。
And look at the department stores and what are selling in terms of the product and the merchandise. Nowadays, the up-end market luxury goods targeting at aged people and the elderly people are selling very well. That is why lately the companies have started to shift their strategy to devote more attention to the development of the goods that would suit the elderly people. That has been the major trend of late. So in addition to targeting at the younger consumers, the richer, wealthier elderly needs to be targeted further because they have amassed lots of savings by now. And people say that in Japan, personal financial assets amounts to 1,760 trillion yen or $15 to $16 trillion. And all these piles of money is standing dormant. So why not direct those money to more of the investment and consumption? And that would be the way that we should adopt ourselves.
Can I ask you about TPP? There has been this change where the Americans have got out. You gave a speech where you seemed to say that you wanted to push ahead with TPP without the Americans. Is that credible? And what comes from that?
TPP というものは今でも少なくとも世界の GDP の約 40% を持つ国々が作るこのアグリメントっていうのは今でも極めて有効なもんだと思っています。
Well, TPP is actually an agreement which encompasses the number of countries who altogether accounts for about 40% of the world's entire GDP. So I would say that this TPP stands very valid at this time as well.
しかし今アメリカは TPP をやめということになりましたので、残りの11カ国で我々はこの TPP を進めた方がいいのではないかと考えています。
But now that the US has decided to withdraw from TPP, right now we are thinking that it might be better for the remaining 11 countries to go ahead with TPP.
アメリカは日本と米の二国間の協議でこの問題をいう話を今トランプ、ペンス副大統領、またウィルバーロス商務長官等々と我々は今しつつし始めているところですけれども、少なくとも12カ国でやったからアメリカにはこれを譲れた。なぜなら他の国から別のものを語って取れたから。しかし二国間となったらアメリカに譲ることはできない。なぜなら他の国取ってくるところがないからということになりますので、二国間の方が今までの TPP よりアメリカがより多く取れるということはないんですという話は何回もしてあります。
That is why just recently, United States and Japan had started to have a consultation between the two countries to deal with this issue. Our counterpart will be Vice President Pence and the Commerce Secretary, Mr. Wilbur Ross, and ourselves. And we have just launched the consultation in this regard. But I could say that if 12 countries work all together, then the concession given to the United States would be beneficial, because other countries would be able to gain from elsewhere because they are working in the country community in the fashion. But if you work solely on the bilateral, then the U.S. won't be able to get further concession, because other countries will not be able to gain conversely or accordingly in return for the concession given to the United States. So it is not a fact that the U.S. will be able to gain more from the bilateral framework than the TPP. It wouldn't hold that way.
よくそれと関連してドルが高いとか円が安いという為替の話もよく出ます。
And, we've been repeating our assertion. And of course, often we hear the word exchange rate, saying that the dollar is too high or yen is too cheap and so forth on the exchange rate level front.
しかし数字を見ていただくと分かるんですが、円が高い時でも円が安い時でも、少なくともアメリカと日本との間で自動車の輸出量は全然変わっていない。それが数字なんであって、今為替の安い高いによって日本の自動車の輸出量がアメリカに向かって変わったことはない。それが事実です。したがって我々はいわゆる為替とかいうような技術的な話ではなくて、構造的なもんで我々は話をしなくてはいかんのではないかというように考えています。
But please look at the actual statistics and numbers. Whether yen is being high or low, in terms of the Japan-US auto trade balance and so forth, the Japanese cars export to the United States have always remained flat, unchanged. That is the what we can learn from the statistics. So regardless of whether a given currency's exchange rate is low or high, as represented by the Japanese auto export to the United States, it remains to be flat and no changes, and that is a fact. So exchange rate issue is a highly technical issue, so we are more for talking all the issues from the structural point of view, and that's what we are trying to do.
And do you expect ultimately America to join the TPP?
Well,
maybe yes or no.
It will take some time, but I think after, しばらく時間はかかると思いますけれども、アメリカはこれに入った方がいいなというように思うと、私どもはそう思いますね。
As I said, it may take some time, but I think U.S. will be feeling that it would be better for the United States after all to go back to TPP. I think that will happen.
Can I ask you about one more question, and then I will throw it open to the audience. Everyone here is most worried about North Korea. What will be the solution there? Does it in the end mean that North Korea has to be unified with South Korea?
Honestly, this is the most serious issue of Japan now. これイギリス人の顔見てて英語になってくるからいかんね。このノースコリアの事実っていうのは、最も日本にとって緊急性のある、最も深刻な問題です。
North Korean issue at the moment is the most urgent and most serious issue for Japan.
4月の25日にいわゆるニュークリアテスト、ニュークリアウェポンの原子爆弾の実験を行うと言われてたんですけど、行わなかった。なかった、良かったっていう話がよくありますけど、それは全然間違ってるんであって、正常、すごい。
On the April the 25th, it was rumored that a nuclear test will be engaged by North Korea, but it didn't happen. So most of the people felt that it was good that no test was conducted. But it's totally wrong to think that way.
明らかに正常じゃない人が危なっかしいおもちゃ持っているという事実は全く変わってないわけですから、解決策は普通じゃない人を普通の人に変わってもらうか、もしくはその危なっかしいおもちゃを取り除くか、どっちかしない限りはこの答えはない、はっきりしてます。
But the person who is not normal or sane is playing with a dangerous toy, and that is a situation which remains to be unchanged. So how to address this issue? One of the two: to turn the insane person to a sane person, or to take away dangerous toy, and that is clear.
Who are you referring to there?
一つはそれをやれるだけの力を持っているのは間違いなく中国であることははっきりしていると思いますので、我々は多分アメリカもそうだと思いますが、今のノースコリアにいきなり民主主義とか資本主義というのを求めるつもりはありません。
For one thing, it is clear that it is China who has the capability and capacity to do so. That is one thing I could say. And also, so is the United States. And I believe that it would be impossible to impose something like a democracy or the capitalism outright to North Korea at this time. It cannot be done.
北朝鮮が南朝鮮化されるということは、その新しい北朝鮮に中北朝鮮米軍が置かれる可能性があるとなれば、それは中国は決して飲むことはないと、そう思います。
So if ever for the northern part to get Koreanized in a South Korean way, then what used to be former North Korea has to be a host for hosting the U.S. Military, which China would detest to see.
したがって北朝鮮のレジームは中国が望むようなものでは全然我々は構わないけれども、少なくとも今の指導者、この人だけは変えてもらえる、これが一つです。
Of course, North Korean regime might not be the ultimate form that China would like to see, but at least what we like to see is to see the change of the current leadership.
もう一つはこの原子爆弾 ICBM インターコンチネンタルバレスティックミサイルっていうこの2つのものを取り除く必要があるんですが、 これを容易に飲まないというんであれば、やることはいくつかあると思いますが、まずは石油です。
So definitely we have to see the total elimination of the nuclear weapon as well as ICBM from North Korea. But North Korea would of course say no to that. But there are some alternative methods that we can resort to. And one is oil.
このオイルはこのトランプさんと習近平さんのフロリダでの会談が終わった後に北朝鮮に対する石油の供給量を減らしたと思われます。なぜなら航空写真、衛星写真を見ればガソリンスタンドに長蛇の列ができてますし、明らかに石油の供給量が減ったか値上げをしたか、何かそういった兆候が起きているはずです。
So, on the point about oil, right after the President Trump and President Xi Jinping's meeting in Florida, it seems that the oil supply to North Korea had gone down or has been reduced because that has been clear from the looking at the aerial photo or the satellite photo. It seems that the long queues are now formed in front of the gas stations. So, it might be due to the dwindling or the reduction of the supply of oil, or may due to the price increase of oil. And those are the signs that, which have been observed.
もう一つは金融です。この金融はバンコデルタアジアっていうマカオの銀行のことを覚えてられるかもしれませんが、この時は間違いなく北朝鮮に金融が止まった。したがって今北朝鮮の輸出の 80% は中国向けですから、そこの金融機関のいわゆる金の送金というのを止めるというのは技術的に可能ですから、それを止めるということになる。そういったようなことが現実として中国、北朝鮮やれる中国の立場から我々アメリカと日本はそれを期待してますけれども、そういった条項にどう北朝鮮が応じてくるかというのが一番の問題です。
One more point is to do something from the financial point of view. Do you remember the case of Banco Delta Asia in Macau? So at that time, the financial flow to North Korea has been stopped.And fact-wise, 80% of the North Korea's export is direct to China. So in terms of the remittance of the money through the financial institutions, it's technically possible to stop that flow or put a halt to it, if so desired. So we really hope that China could also resort to that same method, try to put a stop to the financial flow to North Korea. And that's what Japan and the United States are hoping for. But then what happens? The most difficult issue is what is the reaction coming from the North Korea by doing that?
一番の問題は今のようなことを言えば、普通なら話がなんとなく交渉なり妥結に向かうはずですが、それは相手が普通の人だった時は条件です。相手が普通じゃないというのを条件に考えたら、死なばもろともとかいうことになって、どのみち俺は殺されるんだからというんで、まずは持ってるミサイルみんな撃っちゃおう、グアムには届く、ハワイには届く、日本にはもちろん届く、全部撃っちゃおうなんていうことを考えるかもしれん。また大量の難民が日本海を渡って日本にたどり着く、もちろん韓国にも入っていく、そういった状況っていうのも考えておかなきゃいけませんから、我々としては極めてこの問題については政府にとって非常に大きな問題って考えています。
But the largest issue here is that if our counterparty is a normal person, then of course we could end up having a good negotiation and virtually settle the issue. But that is premised on the fact or the premise that the other counterparty is a normal person. But the counterparty is not a normal person who may think that his destiny can be shared with the rest of the mankind. I will be killed anyway, so why don't I use up and launch all of the missiles that I have in my hand? And it could reach Guam and Hawaii, of course, to the Japan as well. And on top of it, there is going to be a large number of refugees who will be coming over to Japan through Japan's sea and reach the shore of Japanese territory. And it could, of course, easily reach South Korea as well. So those are the serious situations that the Japanese government has to consider. That is why I have said that this is the biggest issue being faced by the government.
Perhaps we can throw open to the floor if you want to ask a question. There are microphones here. Put your hand up. There's a gentleman here and a gentleman there. Maybe keep your questions as short as you can, if possible, and identify yourself.
Hi, it's Kyle Theodore with Insight. I really appreciate you being here. You spoke to incentives and stimulating the economy. You spoke to trying to tap sales to the elderly and the affluent. It seems to me, as an outsider looking in, that one of the issues is demographics and the issue of immigration. What, if anything, are you doing to address the aging of your population?
今の日本として少なくとも移民政策をやって、アメリカとかカナダとかオーストラリアのような移民政策を直ちにやるつもりはありません。
First of all, on the immigration front, we don't have any plan to immediately adopt the immigration policy like those which are being employed by the United States, Canada, or Australia.
今我々はそれを労働力の不足を補うためには、女性の労働参加、高齢者、今日本の平均寿命は男子で83までになってますから、男子の極めて健康な高齢者の雇用、そして女性の労働参加、そしてもう一つがロボットだと思いますが、ロボットの普及率は多分日本が今世界一だと思いますけれども、そういったもので当分の間を補っていくということになると思っています。
So in order to compensate for the labor shortage, what we can do first of all is to empower women to raise the female labor participation rate, and also let the healthy male work longer because the average longevity of a Japanese man is 83. And we could, of course, opt for having women take more part in the labor market. So is the robot as well. I think in terms of the robot, our diffusion rate of a robot might be the world's number one. So for the time being, we will take up those alternative measures to compensate for the labor shortage.
もう一個、先ほどもスピーチの時に述べましたけれども、ワーキングビザというものは間違いなく今日本では技術のある方等々は1年で間違いなくワーキングビザが取れるというのは事実、これ何人かの外国人にも聞きましたけれども、間違いないという話ですから、そういった方 のビザというものは取りやすくなりましたし、いろんな意味で技術を持っている人の労働力というものに関しては解放するというのはもう間違いないとは思いますけれども。
As I said in my speech, it has become a lot easier in Japan to get the working visa. You will need maybe just 1 year to get a working visa successfully in Japan. And I heard directly from the foreigners working in Japan, and they admitted that this is really the case. So in various different ways, we could actively try to tap the people who have a high skill as well as a highly sophisticated technical skill.
Thank you. There's a question here. You might need a microphone if there is.
Microphone, 貸してあげてください。
Hello, Mark Allen with Vice Media. For Society 5.0 to work, it requires technological and scientific breakthroughs in specific industries. Can you tell me where Japan is investing to ensure that they will have those technological breakthroughs?
Technology, no?
社会や技術の突破口を持って
って社会 5.0 が実現できると思うので、あの特にあの投資奨励なさっている分野ってあるでしょうか。
今、シンギュラリティっていう言葉は知ってますか。
Do you know the term singularity?
シンギュラリティで多分今ペギーコンピューターっていうものが今世界で一番速いスーパーコンピューター K っていうスーパーコンピューターを100ペタ、来年中には100ペタ超えるぐらいのところまで行くと思いますけれども、それぐらいのものが出来上がっつつありますんで、これの実験があの 実用が可能になると、少なくとも現物はもう見ましたけれども、少なくともコンピューターっての、スーパーコンピューターって言ったら大きなビルディングが1個ぐらいの大きさですけれども、このペギーコンピューターは電気洗濯機が5台ぐらいの大きさの小さなもんですし、それは、まあ、そこまで、うん。
So, on the note about the singularity, the fastest, the world's fastest computer is now called K, but it's being sophisticated and improved into a piggy computer. So it is said that come the next year, 100 digits and so forth will be able to deal with. So with the practical application of all these developments which are underway, and in fact, I have observed some of the pieces myself, and right now, the supercomputers is huge. It has to be accommodated and housed within the huge building. But come those smaller piggy computers, then it can fit within the 5 units of a washing machine, so to speak.
そして加えて、そのコンピューターは、コンピューターっていうのは熱が出ますんで、それを冷やすために、例えば原子力発電所の10分の1ぐらいの10万キロワットぐらいの電力を使ってクールダウンするため の, あのなんていうのレフレジレーターというか、その空冷する機械がいる、加えてそれはものすごく大きな音がするのはもうご存知の通りですけれども、このペギーコンピューターの場合は小さくて、かつそれは水冷でできてますんで、少なくとも水、本当の水じゃありませんけど、液体でリクイッドでできたものの中にそのコンピューターが入っていますんで、音はしないし熱は出ないし、電力消費量はもうすでに去年世界のグリーン500、あの世界のコンピューターのスーパーコンピューターの電力消費量の少ない順で500台全国登録さ、世界中で登録されてるんですけれども、この登録されているコンピューターの1番と2番はそのペギーコンピューターが2台出して、2台とも世界一の電力消費量の少ないのを取りましたから、そういった意味ではあの我々としてはこれは大きあの投資をするしていこうと狙っている大きな部分の一つです。
You know that computers emit lots of heat, which needs to be cooled. And the power amounting to about 1/10 of a nuclear power plant or equivalent to 100,000 kilowatt worth of power would be needed to cool down the computer. And now it is done by the air, but still the computers tend to be very noisy and so forth, which you might know already. But in case of this piggy-peggy computer coming up, it's much smaller in scale, and it will be cooled using the water. It means that the computer per se will be accommodated within the liquid, and it's less noisy, it emits less heat. And in terms of power consumption, it was certified in terms of the green consumption as of last year. And there is a ranking of top 500 computers which are known for least power consuming. And number one and number two spot have been occupied by this smaller piggy computer because they are very much less power consuming. So those are the areas intentionally that the government intends to invest.Guide the investment.
Another question. There is somebody has, I thought somebody has head up.
Yeah, no.
Question from there.
Good evening. Alfredo from the Central Bank of Mexico. I wanted to know what is your view on the cross-currency basis on the yen given the current situation?
あの、私の立場はご存知かと思いますが、私が今ここで円は少し安いのではないかとか高いのではないかというと、だいたい5分以内に世界の円相場が上がったり下がったりすぐするのが私の今立場なんで、私とスティーブン・ムニューシンの2人は少なくともこの為替の話だけは公の場では絶対しないということになってます、するようにしています。なぜなら為替に即影響が出るんで。今のお答えは私の考え方はありますけれども、やっぱり為替っていうのは市場が決める、そういうふうに考えてことを進めていかないといかんもんだと思っています。
Well, you know that because of my position, if I ever say currently I think the yen is too strong or too weak, then within the span of 5 minutes, global exchange rate market will move. Yen would go up or down depending on the situation. That is what my position can do. Therefore, I myself and my counterpart, Secretary of Treasury, Mr. Steve Mnuchin, we are not supposed to say anything about the exchange rate in a public forum like this, because our remarks would be too impactful on the exchange market. Of course, I do have my own thought, but setting that aside, in a forum like this, we should always say that the exchange rate should be determined by the market, and that is the position that I take.
It is not sadly the position that the President Trump takes. He often makes statements saying the dollar is too strong, and he implies the yen is too weak. And I believe Mr. Mnuchin has to deal with that sometimes. So you, what is your reaction to President Trump? If not to our very patient question.
As a matter of fact, the last time, the most recent one was immediately after what Trump-san said, Mnuchin-san said, well, in a long run, dollar must be strong. That kind of word comes out immediately. So market again, yen goes up, dollar down, and so it consequently same as it was.
Maybe your comments now have a similar effect.
Can be.
But there is a change, though, is that people now see Japan as a safe haven in some ways, as a place. The yen is a safe haven. Some people think they think that they see Japan as an element of security in a world where other people are less reliable.
今の日本が少ないってわけね。It is, even in Japanese, it is very difficult to give you an answer, but... あの、今の話は間違いなく戦争というものを、例えば北朝鮮で何か起きた場合に円がどうなるかっていうようなことは常に考えておかなければなりませんので、ご年配の方なら、私より年が上の方なら、朝鮮事変っていうのを記憶している人もいらっしゃいます。で、そういう方たちは北朝鮮、朝鮮半島でことが起きれば、間違いなくロジスティックスとかバックアップっていうことになると、間違いなくアメリカは日本にその輸送とか補充とかいうのを頼みますんで、それは日本の消費に非常に大きくなるから円が上がるだろうという人もいらっしゃいますし、逆に攻撃されれば円が下がるだろうと思われる方もいらっしゃいますんで、あの、今の言いましたように、円が安定してると言われれば、北朝鮮のことを考えたらとてもじゃない、今円というのは極めてインビギュアス、あの、不安定なものなんだと私には思いますけど。
Of course, about your remarks, we should always make ourselves ready to think about what the yen would be like if something happens in North Korea, some events. So 5 years ago, there were men who were older than me who really witnessed the Korean War way back. So just thinking about whether some events could happen in the Korean Peninsula. Of course, some would say that because the transport and supply and the airlift and everything else would be provided by the United States under the circumstances, which could boost the consumption in Japan. So that could also raise the value of yen. That's one way of thought. But there is another camp of people who would say that no, that will not happen. It's totally opposite because Japan will be attacked so that the yen would go down in value. And you have alluded that perhaps the yen is being a stable currency at this time. But if you take into consideration the possibility emanating from North Korea, I wouldn't say that the yen is that stable. Yen can be very unstable currency at the moment.
Finance Minister, thank you very much. You've taken us all the way from Nob Hill to nuclear destruction. But thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.